This one is just pinned up, and this is one that fits on like that. So this has got the welt strip on it. It's alder. I've tapered the toe. I've put a rubber sole on. I put very little tiny tingles just to hold the leather in place, so I don't entirely trust the glue. And this has a three nail outer toe tin in brass. This one is a different style. It's a more rounded toe. It's going to have a buckle or a button to hold it down there. That's how it's going to fit. It's pretty much finished. It only needs the button to go on and me to take the last out. This has got an inner. So this has got a toe tin that just sits on the ledge, whereas this one goes around the outside. I tend to prefer these, but these are more delicate. These look more delicate. But these protect the wood, whereas this just protects the leather and can be a point of weakness. You have to put very light nails in because you don't want to just sort of make the wood like a piece of toilet paper that has so many holes in it it's going to break off. So I don't use these very often, and I've got probably, as a result, I've got enough totins, traditional totins, left to see me out, whereas these ones I have to have made up now. I've run out of that style. All the pairs I make are made to measure. I don't make standards. She wanted alder, so she's got an alder sole, and she wanted this toe tin, she wanted it in blue, she wanted it with steel nails. I've got smaller nails here. A lot of clog makers use the same size nail all the way around, but I don't. They're not supposed to do that. You don't need a heavy nail at the toe. There's very little stress on it, so you put a smaller nail. This one happens to have it's a smaller head, but then I've got, say, these are maybe 1/2 inch, 3/8. Then you're talking about 1/2 inch, 5/8, and then I've got 7/8 around the back. That's the vamp in clog term, if I got this right, and these are the quarters. So the front's called the vamp and the rear is called the quarters. No idea why. So I'm using a standard clasp front with actually one of my shoe uppers patterns. This is what, when I used to make shoes a lot, and one or two people wanted their clogs like this. So I've got a strap over and a bolt. Now the interesting thing about this is you can't see it. Inside here, this is level, right through to here. So her toe stops about there, and she can't easily, without pain, bend her foot. So what I've done is I've taken the curve out, and she's got a flat platform inside to put her foot on, and she can still walk in these quite naturally because they've got a roll in them. Obviously, if she can't bend her foot easily, it's not particularly painless for her to walk. So we're hoping that she'll be able to walk pain-free in these. It's not very easy to walk without a big toe, but with a clog, you're not walking off your toe, you're just rolling along. So if you've got problems such as that, you can deal with that with a clog. People with a foot problem that needed support, we've worked off a plaster cast and carved the sole in the curve of the plaster cast. Actually, I've made two soles. I've made a sole to put the last on to stretch the upper, and then I've taken it off that and put it onto the sole that her foot's going to go on. That worked fine. The last one I did, I hadn't heard from her for 2 years, and then she suddenly popped up and said they needed resoling, and I said, oh, they worked, and she went, oh yeah, they're great. So that was good. So there's various things that you can do. They don't have to be clogs. You could do some of the stuff with shoes, but if people have difficulty bending their feet but they want a natural walking gait, you can get around that with clogs.